Today, I'm going to show you a new technology for generating digital humans using audio, called Longcat Video Avatar. This model supports two modes of video generation. The first method uses an audio prompt combined with a reference image to generate the video. The second method doesn't use a reference image at all. It generates the video using only audio and text prompts. The results generated have been somewhat controversial. Actually, Kijai's One Video extension has supported this model for a while now, but it was previously in a separate branch. It wasn't until yesterday that it was merged into the main branch. Many influencers have already reviewed this workflow, and the feedback has been mixed. However, my own testing results have been quite good. In this video, we will focus on three specific workflows. The first one is Kijai's original workflow. It consists of two parts, generating a base video and then extending that base video. By using this method, you can theoretically generate videos of infinite length. Let's take a look at the generated results.
The sky is gray and blue as I wait for you. The fire in my heart, burning white and true. 1,000 miles, the smoke is rising high both sides.
The overall effect is decent, though some might find it a bit stiff. Also, the extension process here is done manually. Because of that, I built a second workflow for you. This second workflow is completely automated, and I've also tuned the generation parameters to a certain extent to give the visuals more movement. Let's look at the result.
The sky is gray and blue as I wait for you. The fire in my heart, burning white and true.
You can see at the end, there's even a motion of eating grapes. So contrary to what many have said in their tests about motion not working, it is achievable. The third workflow includes two main improvements. First, I remove the camera zoom in motion to keep the character's full body in frame. Second, I generated a much longer video to see if this automatic generation is truly effective. If you want to use this model, you just need to update Kijai's One Video extension to the latest version, download this workflow, and drag it into your Comfy UI. Regarding the model download, you can open Kijai's repository list on Hugging Face. Inside the Longcat series models, you'll see a folder called Avatar. Click on that. Inside, there are two models. One is FP8 and the other is BF16. You can choose the model that fits your GPU's computing power. Later on, we will also use an acceleration model, so you might want to download that in advance as well. I have also built this workflow on Running Hub. For Comfy UI, Running Hub is a fantastic online workbench because whenever new extensions or technologies appear, they update immediately. You can register for Running Hub using the invitation link in my video description to get 1,000 free points. Plus, you get 100 points daily just for logging in, which lets you test your own workflows. Now, what you are seeing is Kijai's original workflow. I'll show you an optimized version later, but the basic structure is the same. Let's first look at the basic composition of this workflow. First, we have the main model loading. Here we are using the Longcat Avatar BF16 model we saw earlier. Note the attention type if you want to select Sage Attention. Your version needs to be at least 2.0. We also have an acceleration LoRA, our VAE, and the vision encoder. Below that is the reference image section. Note that our current image is 916. We resize it and encode it into latent space. For the audio section, I uploaded an audio clip. You can listen to it.
The sky is gray and blue as I wait for you.
It is an English song, about 33 seconds long. We have an audio trimming node where you can cut out the length you want. Below that, I use a feature for track separation. Since the input audio might have background music, we use this node to separate the background music from the vocals, as we only need the vocals. Then we use a multi-talk or infinite talk node. This node essentially performs wave-to-vector, converting sound into a vector, which then goes into our sampling section. Pay attention to the basic configuration here. First is our resolution. I've set it to 480 by 832. Then we have frames per window. This means the model has a sliding window capability, allowing it to generate long videos via extension. We set the frame count to 93 instead of the traditional 81. Why? Because when we extend the video, we need an overlap between the old and new clips. This overlap is 13 frames. If we take 93 and subtract 13, we get the standard 81 frames. The CFG is set to 1.0 next. we enter the sampling stage. Before sampling, we have a prompt. Currently, the prompt is a beautiful girl is singing. Then we use a very important node called Long Cat Avatar Image Embeds. Its main function is to generate our image embedding vectors, which are used during sampling. To generate this, we need a reference latent, which is the latent generated from encoding our reference image. For the scheduler, we have some specific settings. We chose a specialized long cat scheduler. The shift value is set to 12. Regarding sampling steps, KGI's official setting is 12 steps, but I felt that was a bit slow, so I changed it to 8 steps. The results with 8 steps are actually fine. After the first sampling, we decode it and that generates our first video. Let's listen to it.
The sky is gray and blue, it's a way for you.
As you can see, the lip sync effect is quite good. Now let's extend it. Extension naturally happens on top of the base video we just generated to make it longer. Here, it performs two extensions. The extension workflow is identical to the base generation, but let's look at the difference. This workflow has two lines, the top one and the bottom one. Let's look at the bottom one first. We take the first generated video, we use the embedding node again, but slightly differently. In the first pass, we use the reference image as the previous latent, but here, we use the first generated video as the previous latent, while our reference image is connected to reference latent. That is the biggest difference, everything else is basically the same. After sampling again, we generate a new video segment. The operation above performs post-processing on this generated segment. First, we take the last 13 frames. These are the overlapping frames. We VAE encode them into latent space and perform a replacement. Then we stitch them together. Of course, when stitching, we must remove those 13 overlapping frames. For this, we use a familiar node called Image Batch, extend with overlap. After that, you see the second video segment.
The sky is gray and blue, it's a way for you. The fire in my heart, burning white and true.
The quality is also very high. Then we extend it again to generate a third segment.
The sky is gray and blue, it's a way for you. The fire in my heart, burning white and true. 1,000 miles, the smoke is rising high both sides.
We didn't render the entire video here, just 15 seconds. There's one thing I need to explain. In this node, our FPS is set to 32, but when generating the video, the frame rate is set to 16. There's a note here explaining that because the audio stride equals 2, when we set FPS to 32, the real output is 16. Just be aware of that. That was the first workflow. Its biggest drawback is that it's not automatic. You have to calculate how many times you need to extend. So I built an automated workflow for you. The beginning parts are identical. We focus on the extension part. First, we generate a base video. Then we have a loop. For the loop, we must calculate the total number of iterations. I added some logic here. I have a node called Math Expression. First, we have exact audio frames, which refers to the total frames generated by the audio, since the frame rate is 32. If you take 10 seconds, you get 320 frames. But since our final output is 16 frames per SECond, I first divide it by 2 to eliminate that doubling difference. Then how many frames do we generate each time? We generate 93 frames total, but 13 are overlap, so we generate 80 new frames per Pascal SS. That's B minus E. We round up and then subtract 1. Why subtract 1? Because we already generated the base video first. So minus 1 gives us the final loop count. Then we enter the loop. We connect the first generated video to initial value 1 and the first generated latent to initial value 2. The content below is exactly the same as before, except I connected value 1 to the image input here and value 2 to the previous latent. After updating, I connect the newly generated video back to initial value 1 and the generated latent back to initial value 2. This makes the entire workflow automatic. Let's listen to the result.
The sky is gray and blue, it's a way for you. The fire in my heart, burning white and true. 1,000 miles.
You might notice two things about this video. First, the lip movements seem much larger. Second, at the very end of the video, the visuals glitch out. Why is that? Notice that I adjusted the audio scale to 2.0 kijai. Provided a tip stating that audio scale can be set between 3 and 5 to enhance lip movement range. So I tried adjusting it. The default is 1.0 and I set it to 2.0. The result, as you saw, did have larger lip movements, but it caused the video to collapse at the end. It seems 2.0 was a bit too aggressive. So how do we fix this glitch? Let's look at the third workflow. Here is the final result.
The sky is crying blue, it's a way for you. The fire in my heart, burning white and true.
This one has more motion. Not only is she singing, but she is also eating grapes. I made two main improvements here. First, I set the audio scale to 1.5. Since we tested 2.0 and it was too high, I dialed it back. Second, I changed the prompt. Originally, I wrote girl is singing, but now I wrote girl is eating grapes. You'll find that the prompt has a significant guiding effect on the video. This final workflow is essentially a test of the automatic generation over a longer duration. Earlier, I only did 10 seconds base plus one extension. I was worried that multiple extensions might cause issues. So here, I generated a longer video of 15 seconds base video plus two extensions to ensure we get a stable final result.
The sky is crying blue, it's a way for you. The fire in my heart, burning white and true. 1,000 miles, the smoke is rising high both sides.
To wrap up, in this video, we covered the original workflow, the fully automated workflow I built for you, and how to optimize the entire process. I recommend you try out each workflow. It will help you understand the model deeply and use it more effectively. That's all for today. Follow me to become an expert in AI.